was nominated, I was excited, and when I was a finalist, I was even more excited.
Very, very thrilled.
Surprised, humbled when I realized the company I was in.
Really, truly honored and humbled.
I was so honored. Athena is such a big thing here on Long Island.
It was amazing. It was an incredible feeling. I was proud.
It's just humbling to be a part of a fantastic group and to be part of what I call very strong values and very strong women's leadership.
There are 8 key principles to Athena, and they're all so important, and I do live them day to day, but I think the one that sticks out for me the most is to live authentically, because I started my career at TD Bank when I was young, right out of school, and I was my authentic self right from the start, which made it very easy to show up to work every day and build relationships with people because I wasn't trying to be something that I'm not.
I think two that really stuck out for me is collaboration and giving back. I think being in the nonprofit world my entire career, obviously giving back is at the forefront of everything I do.
Giving back is something that's really important, and it doesn't take a lot to give somebody something to smile about, so I really try to live my life by doing that.
I've had some really wonderful role models in medical care, in medicine. I wanted to be academic, I wanted to teach, and through my training over the years, I've just had very strong role models that I came across with.
So there's many people who have influenced my life and my journey to date. I would say someone that stands out for me would be Catherine Heaviside, who's the president of Epic 5 Public Relations. She herself is an Athena recipient, and she's mentored me over the years to not only be a better leader within my organization and with my staff, but a community leader and a business advocate.
There's been so many people that have influenced my life in terms of my leadership role. I had parents that served as amazing leaders professionally and personally. My mom in particular, who was a really successful businesswoman as a single parent without the formal education that I was lucky enough that she afforded me.
I have so many people to thank in terms of my career journey. It would be too many to, I think, name on video, but I'm very cognizant of careers are really made with other people helping you. And then I also feel very passionate about helping other people with their careers.
I'd be really proud of it. I think it would exemplify not only the work that I have been able to do, but my team has been able to do over the years.
Being an award recipient would truly be an honor for me. It's the Athena framework embodies everything that I want to carry on in my day-to-day life. And although I feel like I've been in my career a long time, coming up on 10 years, I'm just getting started.
I think the entire tenet of Athena is just fantastic for women and really represents some opportunities for all of us, and I would be honored and humbled to be a recipient.
I've really tried to live my life giving back where I can, getting involved with other organizations, things that I care about, things that I'm passionate about, and also educating the people around me to do the same.
I serve on the Long Island Coalition for the Homeless Board, the Advanced Health Network Board, WEDLI, which is Women Economic Developers of Long Island. I feel like you can situate yourself in a better place by helping to serve.
Being in the nonprofit world, giving back has always been ingrained in me, but more recently, a few years ago, I had the opportunity to volunteer at the Center for Integration and Advancement of New Americans. So it's a nonprofit organization that really gives back in terms of consulting to new immigrants here in New York, across the island, as well as in Queens. And I've been fortunate enough to be an elementary school tutor there for the past 3 years, and it is it's tremendous. It's something that I look forward to every week. I do it 2 nights a week when I can and when we don't have meetings, but it's been a tremendous part of my life over the last few years, and it's the best way that I give back.
Over the years, I've been on boards for schools. I've been on neighborhood community zoning boards. I've coached softball and lacrosse. So I've really tried to give back with the idea of community. My name is Maria Torroella Carney, and I am Athena.
My name is Yolanda Robano Gross, and I am Athena.
My name is Linda Armin, and I am Athena.
My name is Danielle McKenna, and I am Athena.
My name is Sadia Mahmood, and I am Athena.
My name is Meredith McCaslin, and I am Athena.
My name is Chris Reardon, and I am Athena.